chance for Garthwaite. The ball comes clear now. Here's a chance for Philandia. Philandia's kick out wide. A little bit too far for the Essendon player to mark it. He gathers it nicely. It's Tonks. And his kick is a shocker. And that really is the difference. The North Melbourne players, very composed when they kick the football. McGrath's kick up towards half forward. No mark taken. Chance there for Essendon's Pennell. Again, another chance. A quick kick. He might get his third possession. It's beautiful smother off the boot. And somehow that North Melbourne player gets his kick away. Up towards half forward. Carey's there. So is Venner. Good tidy up by Hay. Hay's kick towards full forward. Over the back. Now the Essendon defence under pressure. There's a chance here for Gadsden. He slips at the crucial stage. Gets the looping hand pass out wide. In his support there is Garthwaite. Hand pass over the top back to Gadsden. Gadsden's kick as Hay comes in. Overrunning it there is Leighton. He's after it again. Helped out by Barwick. Leighton goes after it again, but the boundary line too close. And he takes it over as O'Brien arrives a little late on the scene for Essendon.
John Rocky left the ground with what looks like a leg injury. He was carried off by the two trainers. He's sitting there. It doesn't appear to be too serious.
Daffy in front of Venner, but Venner gets the big punch towards the North Melbourne goal and gathers about 15 metres for his team as the Essendon bench work feverishly on Rocky's leg. A boundary throw in again. 12 and a half minutes left in the third quarter. Chance for O'Donnell. Great punch out by Venner. Kick up towards full forward. Tap on. Well, struggle for possession. Christie there. Palmer. Chance now for Davies for Essendon. Here's O'Donnell. Swoops on it. Right foot snapshot for goal. Up into the forward pocket area and it's punched over the line by the Essendon defender in Gadsden. And he's struggling hard down there for his side.
It's a good play there by Christie too, the tall North Melbourne forward, who did a lot of good constructive work on the forward line, tapping it on and chased and ran hard trying to set up a chance for the North Melbourne forwards.
Venner takes it out of the ruck contest. Snapshot is high in the air and the mark's been taken there for Essendon by Pennell.
Courage there from Pennell. Kept his eyes on the ball until it landed in his arms.
They really don't do much with the football when they get possession, do they? The Bombers. Barrow scouting the packs nicely. Gets around somehow. Back onto the right foot now. And kicks it 45 metres up towards the wing. But who's there? That North Melbourne strong defence again. McGrath takes an easy chest mark. Short pass is effective. Cracker. Hand pass over the top. He's put his teammate under enormous pressure. And there's a free kick being picked out of it. It'll go back there to Watson for North Melbourne. Watson on centre wing will put North Melbourne back into attack. They really do look composed. And they're well coached by Dennis Pagan. One says that Ray Jordan is the doyen of under 19 coaches, but Dennis Pagan must be just in there behind him because he's taken this North Melbourne under 19s team to their sixth successive grand final appearance. They've won two premierships and lost three, and this one is looking very, very much like theirs for the taking. Oh, struggle there for possession by Davies. And he's dragged to the ground by the North Melbourne player, and he'll take the free kick.
That's just about a reportable incident. Tackles like that. There's no part in the game for that sort of tackle. Let me have a look at this again. There's a couple of North Melbourne players really went headhunting.
Young Andrew Cracker, I think, wasn't it?
He was one,
Bernie,
of them.
Well, North Melbourne go into attack again. It's up into their, right into their 10-metre square, and it's rushed through for another behind. So their score goes on to 11-10, 76. And their lead now stretched to 62 points. Essendon, a paltry 2-2-14.
A couple of Essendon changes. Philandia and Daffy off. Onto the ground comes Shane Ryan and Rocky, who wasn't seriously injured at all.
Kick in with 10 minutes left in the third quarter. North Melbourne at half forward. Essendon keeping it in. I probably would have thought that they'd have been better off taking it over the line, but they're going to get clear. The high ball goes into the centre, comes to the back, Chance now for O'Donnell. He gets it off to McGrath. McGrath, neat and tidy on both sides of his body. Kicks it out wide in front of Cracker. Boundary line a little bit too close as the Essendon player in Doyle crashes Cracker to the ground right on the 50-metre line. We'll have another boundary throw-in. So North Melbourne doing it nicely. 11-10 plays 2-2. And the big, tall figure of Venner gets the ball out to the back. Chance there was for Watson. Here's another goal coming up. And it's kicked nicely by Hay. He kicks his third.
Nissan Nomad now combines features like power steering, rear coil spring suspension, a convenient rear lift window, and Nissan's 2-year warranty. Nissan Know-How. Building the right cars for Australia.
If you need a locksmith, do what I do.
Use the Melbourne Big. It's much faster.
The Melbourne Big. The buying guide Melbourne into turning to.
So 19 minutes into the third quarter, and it's a 68-point lead for North Melbourne, and they look to have their hands on the flag.
Another chance coming up for them through Tudor. Tudor inside 50 metres, goes with the left foot. Bit of shepherding by Cracker, close to the line, and it just bounces on the wrong side of the big post for another behind. Taking the ball out of the centre a little too easily. Kicking in to be done by Doyle. Goes into the back pocket. Kicked on by Garthwaite. Over the top of O'Brien's head, and it's thumped over the line by Davis for North Melbourne. The ball between centre wing and half forward for North Melbourne. It's all North Melbourne. 12-11, plays 2-2. Essendon coming from the elimination final. Chance for North Melbourne again. High ball up towards full forward. No mark. Now Garthwaite kicks the ball wide towards centre wing member's side. The bouncing ball. Hard to control. A hand pass over the top by Meadew. Chance for Kennaway. Little slow, but he gets the hand pass back to Meadew, who's run on nicely. Kicks it into the forward pocket. No mark taken. Lupson. Chance to kick Essendon's third goal. Kick it quickly. Hook kick is not bad. It's a goal. So Essendon's third coming up at the 20-minute mark of the third quarter. Lupson.
Yes, great play there from Lupson. He's one Essendon player that's really had a good go at it today. And there it is again. Lupson went for the mark, recovered well onto that left foot, and an excellent goal from about 45 metres out on the run. So Essendon get their third. They've struggled all afternoon, all morning to get the goals on the board. And Lupson has shown a lot of spirit to kick that goal.
Well, it's a long haul back, but it's one. 12-11 to 3-2.
Back in the centre. Essendon may get clear. No, they can't. O'Donnell. He's crashed to the ground there by Boyden. And Boyden a little disappointed with the umpiring decision. The free kick will go to O'Donnell.
Might have been entitled to. That was a good hard bump, I thought, there from Boyden.
So O'Donnell kicks North Melbourne up towards centre half forward. At the back, a good mark taken for Essendon by Ryan. Ryan transfers play to the half-back flank on the member's side. Garthwaite, short kick, intercepted nicely for North Melbourne by Scholl. Scholl goes back towards the Essendon goal, and a chance for Angus. Takes the mark and plays on, kicks it up towards half-forward. And an unopposed mark there taken by Davis. He plays on, his kick is smothered. Essendon will come forward through Napoli. Napoli's hand pass. Goes up towards half forward now. Here's another opportunity for Lupson. Deep in the forward pocket. Oh, he's tackled, thrown to the ground there by McCormack. And we'll have a boundary throw-in. So, breaking down there.
Good tackle from McCormack. Lupson had the ball. And when he was tackled, I thought he let it go. So it was almost a free kick. Could have been paid to McCormack.
The play is about 35 metres around from the Essendon goal. So maybe the Young Bombers can get their fourth goal out of this forward attempt here. Deep in the half forward area for Essendon, the umpire has decided to bounce once again. Davies there for Essendon. And the player there for North Melbourne is Watson. 17 for North Melbourne is Tyrrell. ruck contest. Barrow can't break clear. Good tackle. Chance now for Essendon through Rocky. North Melbourne striving hard. The player Davis. Now Rocky again. Kick around the corner. May bounce through. Rocky's kick is going to kick Essendon's four.
Mystery and wonder. The world around us returns with a premiere special film throughout the Victorian Central Highlands, where the volcanoes roared. Prehistoric history, the dream time, bushrangers, gold seekers, early pioneers, and the infamous Hanging Rock. 6:30 tonight, The World Around Us on 7.
So a couple of quick goals to make Essendon's trip to the MCG feel worthwhile, but they still trail pretty heavily.
Kick out of the centre ruck contest by Cracker, and the mark's been taken at half back by Doyle. Doyle, he's tried very hard. His torpedo punt kick goes over 50 metres, but the mark's been taken in defence for North Melbourne by Angus. He plays on quickly, kicks it wide out into the open spaces. There's a chance out there for Garthwaite for Essendon. He tidies up nicely, kicks it into the centre, and a mark's been taken there by Ryan. His long hand pass puts his teammate under enormous pressure, but he's up to it, and he gets the ball clear. That's O'Brien up towards full forward, and the mark's been taken by Lupson. So there's a bit of a revival here by the Essendon under-19 boys. They've kicked two goals in this quarter, and one of them came through Lupson, the other one through Rocky, and now Lupson has the opportunity to kick Essendon's fifth goal.
He's the one shining light, isn't he, up on the forward line, Lupson?
Well, he started in defence, I thought, Bernie, and moved up into the forward line. He kicks for goal and hits the post. So Venner has been replaced while that action was going on. The big North Melbourne ruckman limped off the ground, and Lupson kicks a behind for Essendon. So the kicking in will be done by McCormack for North Melbourne. Beautiful kick out past the 50-metre line. Chance for Angus up towards half forward. Oh, there's two or three North Melbourne forwards really striving to keep the ball in. It comes clear now through Davies. Davies for Essendon. Cracker. Good effort there by Andrew Cracker. And he gets the free kick. He plays on quickly. Up towards half forward. And the mark's been taken there by Carey. Carey now kicks the North Melbourne side up towards the 10-metre square. No mark taken. Pennell there to pick up the crumbs. A quick kick to the safety of the boundary line on the 50-metre line. Palmer there for North Melbourne, and we'll see another boundary throw-in.
North Melbourne forwards have gone out of the game slightly. Carey not as dominant as he was in that first half.
The big player there for North Melbourne was Rozelle, who's come on to replace Venner. Oh, interception is brilliant by Manara. He goes for goal and misses. Another behind to North Melbourne. Great opportunity there for Manara. North Melbourne now 12-12, leading Essendon 4-3. And we're into time on in the third quarter. Doyle for Essendon comes to the members' side. No mark taken. Chance for Essendon's Meadhew. He can't control it, and we'll have another boundary throw-in. Free kick, says the boundary umpire, and it looks as though it might go to North Melbourne.
Yes, it must have been.
The boundary umpire really is going towards the North Melbourne goal. Now he's indicating, yes.
Yeah, the boundary umpire was a bit uncertain, unsure of which way they were going.
So were the players, I think, Bertie, there. Nearly a good mark to North Melbourne. Chance for the Essendon player, Tonks. Good tackle by Kennaway. Up towards half forward, Tudor. Pushed in the back by Pennell, and the umpire saw it that way, much to the disgust of Pennell, and the free kick will go to Tudor. He plays on quickly, and disciplined football, kicks it to the front of the square, no mark taken. Snapshot there by Watson, into the square, and the mark's been taken by the big fellow, Carey. So the centre half forward takes the mark in the goal square, and a fairly simple shot coming up for North Melbourne's 13th goal, quite possibly.
Very good statistics.
Yeah, Carey with two goals already has been the dominant forward, or one of the dominant forwards on the North Melbourne forward line. The other good player, Mark Hay, has kicked three goals. And they've got too many talented players on that forward line. There's so many players there who can kick goals. The other big player, Christie, has done well also. Here's a shot for goal from Carey. Only from about 10 metres out. He's made no mistake with that one. It's another goal to North Melbourne. North Melbourne now lead 12-12, 13-12-90 to Essendon 4-3-27.
Yes, it's a bit of a hiding, really, isn't it, when the consider how much time's left, just a quarter and a bit.
Here's the mark again to Carey. A good, strong player at centre-half forward. Under a little bit of pressure there from Gadsden. And a good, strong chest mark, and no mistake from about 10 metres out on that slight angle.
Jeez, a couple of these guys grow a bit in height and in size. They'll be tremendous players for North in the future. So, back in the centre. Big punch away by the Essendon ruckman. Barrow there striving for possession. So is Rocky. But the umpire decides on another bounce. Close to three-quarter time in the VFL Under-19 Grand Final between North Melbourne and Essendon. North Melbourne comfortably at this stage, 13-12-90, leading Essendon 4-3-27. And the North Melbourne ruckman there now, Rozelle, kick away there for Essendon by Tranter. Nearly a possession to Tudor, but tidied up by Pennell for Essendon. Kick out wide to the practice cricket pitch area, close to the line. North Melbourne through late and come clear and repel that Essendon attack. Up towards centre wing, no mark taken. Chance for Scholl. Scholl's kick up towards full forward, and a good clean mark has been taken by Christie. Inside the 50-metre line, goes with the drop punt. May bounce through, close to the line. Essendon take possession of the football through Garthwaite, but it's through for a behind to North Melbourne. So 64 points the difference in favour of North Melbourne. Kick in done by Doyle. Past the 50 metre line, no mark. And there's the siren to end the third term. And at three quarter time, the scoreboard very much in favour of North Melbourne. North Melbourne 13-13-91, Essendon 4-3-27.
Nissan Patrol, the most advanced four-wheel drive down under. It makes all other four-wheel drives seem primitive. With Go Anywhere Patrol's all-new four-coil suspension, you get the handling and ride comfort of the car. Patrol's powerful 4.2-litre diesel or petrol sixes leave all other four-wheel drives back in the Stone Age. Nissan Patrol. It's Australia's 4x4 of the year. That's Nissan know-how, building the right vehicles for Australia.
NEC make the most popular fax machines in Australia. One reason is speed. Every second your fax takes to transmit interstate or overseas costs money. NEC make a knee fax that's so fast it can transmit a page in 9 seconds. Other faxes can take much longer. Being fast keeps us one step ahead. No fax beats knee fax.
Born to fly. Born to run away like an eagle.
Like an eagle.
Born to fly. Born to get away. Get away. Born to fly. Born to get away. I was born to fly.
We have the people, the technology. We're ready to respond to a crime being committed in only minutes. Your call. But you must call D24 direct on 11444.
Not away, VKC.
3 minutes, VKC. Only 4 blocks away, VKC.
You need the police in a hurry. Call D24 direct on 11444.
We're building pools and dreams.
You can kick a goal during the finals with the aquatic team.
That's right, Bob. If you order a pool during September, you'll be swimming by Christmas. Aquatic guaranteed. And we'll even hand pass you a special bonus offer. Solar heating absolutely free. Now that gets high marks.
Don't just dream it, do it. See Aquatic now.
We're building pools and trees, Aquatic pools.
What do the Tigers say to drink driving?
Not on.
Forget it.
Never.
It was a better quarter by Essendon. They kicked a couple of goals, but in turn, just when you think North Melbourne's gone to sleep, they slam in a couple themselves. They kicked 5-5, so it's 13-13, 91 to 4-3-27. Well, this afternoon in the big one, certainly one of the feature players to watch for Hawthorn, Jason Dunstall.
Fast becoming the league's best full forward, Hawthorn's Jason Dunstall is regarded as one of the most accurate kicks in the VFL. 23-year-old Dunstall was spotted by the Hawks playing for Brisbane club Coorparoo, and since his first senior match in 1985, the speedy Hawk has been a consistent goal kicker for his club. Not only does Dunstall regularly finish off the work from upfield, he's also extremely creative with his tap-ons and use of handball.
Looking forward to seeing Jason play, but turning our attention to this match, and really, Ian, it's a lost cause, it looks, for Essendon at the moment.
I think North Melbourne, with their big players, right from the ruck contest, Bernie Venner was tremendous. We mentioned player Carey, Angus, Christie, Scholl, all guys over 190 centimetres, and they really have been a thorn in Essendon's side all day long.
Yes, there's plenty of height in this North Melbourne side. And Essendon, although they've tried hard, they just haven't had the class players to match the North Melbourne youngsters. There's a good goal, one of the goals kicked in this third quarter. Kicked there by John Rocky, and that player Lupson, number one on picture there, did very well playing at full forward in that quarter. But the North Melbourne players have got too many good players up in that forward line. The ruckman, well, Venner went off in that quarter, and he was replaced by Rozelle, another 195 centimetre player. There's a marker Carey, who was very busy on the forward line, went out of a little bit that quarter, but still they've got so many class players. One player goes out of it, another one takes over.
The kicks, 120 to North Melbourne, Essendon 79. The difference there really tells you something. Marks, the marking power also with North Melbourne, and right down the stats, it's the same story. Shots at goal 26 to 7, and that's reflected in the scoreline. I thought just for a moment there that North Melbourne were having a bit of a holiday after looking at the scoreboard and seeing themselves 70 points in front. Essendon kicked a couple, and but then it just seemed they can put the pedal down when they want to.
Yeah, there's no lies there with the statistics. They really have been the superior side right from the start of the match, where they kicked 6 goals, 4 in the first quarter to Essendon's 2 goals.
There's Dennis Pagan going in, the North Melbourne coach. He's been had a great record with the under-19s here.
So the start of the last quarter coming up for the grand final of the under-19s. North Melbourne well in control, and they go forward from that first bounce up towards half forward. It's been broken down by the Essendon defence. They kick it clear towards centre wing, and there's a good mark to North Melbourne taken by Layden. He plays on quickly. A hand passes to Tudor. Tudor's kick up towards full forward. No mark taken. Chance for Christie. Christie's quick kick out of that marking contest into the forward pocket. Nearly a gather there by Hay, that he couldn't control it, and it goes over the line for a boundary throw-in.
He's been a very good player, Hay, hasn't he, all afternoon? He's kicked 3 goals and had a hand in a couple of others. Here's the boundary throw-in. Christie doing the ruck work on the forward line. Essendon can clear this one out of the back line. Back to the half-back line, where a safe chest mark's taken by the North Melbourne side.
So North Melbourne will go into attack. The hand pass goes across, and the kick in towards the forward pocket area. Good punch away. There's a chance now for Watson, who leads in the race for the ball. Right on the 50-metre line, a good gather. The tackle by Rocky was ineffective. Now O'Donnell kicks it off the side of his boot over the line on the full. And that really was one of their rare poor pieces of play, North Melbourne.
He was under a little bit of pressure, but he hurried that kick instead of centering it, going for the, I suppose, the safety or the percentage play. He really went for the shot at goal when the centering kick would have been the more effective.
So the Essendon player Davies will take the free kick in the back pocket, and their task looks quite fruitless. The Bombers, they trail by over 9 goals, over 10 goals at the start of this quarter. Now North Melbourne, a chance for Scholl, hard up against the boundary line. His kick wasn't bad though, he hooked it back. The Essendon player Ryan coming clear, kick out wide, and the mark has been taken by O'Donnell. So O'Donnell will put North Melbourne back into attack. He's got the football on centre wing, no one really taking the mark. His kick up towards half forward. Chance now for Carey. It goes over the line in front of Ryan, and we'll have another boundary throw in. So the play is just inside the 50 metre line for North Melbourne. No score from either side so far in this last term. Ryan striving hard, so is Doyle. Gather now by Christie. His kick is offline. It's not Christie. But 33 was Tolrar for North Melbourne, one of their interchange players who came on in the third quarter. Now the kick back will be done by Garthwaite. So Essendon, they really haven't given up the ghost, but they haven't had enough players across their half forward line to get the play up into their full forward area. The kick now, beautiful mark, nearly taken. It's been paid. A diving attempt by Christie.
A bit lucky to be paid that one. Bit lucky.
He was too. It slipped through, didn't it, Bernie? And certainly hit the grass.
Yes, the umpire was quick with the whistle.
There's an Essendon player in the hands of the trainers.
He collided with his teammate in the centre of the ground. There it is, the two Essendon players colliding. Napoli's the player that hit the ground. Here's the kick for goal from Christie. Long shot right through the middle. Another goal to North Melbourne.
Presenting Nissan's award-winning four-wheel drive freedom machine, Pathfinder.
It's a beachcomber, a mountain climber, a highway cruiser, bush hiker, night stalker. Come and drive Pathfinder.
Nissan Pathfinder, now with even better performance. Now in two exciting models at your Nissan dealer. Nissan know-how, building the right vehicle for Australia.
Well, if they hadn't sealed it at three-quarter time, they have now, North Melbourne, 14-13-97 to 4-3-27.
The quick kick out of the centre. The mark has been taken by Layden. He plays on and kicks it around the corner up towards half-forward. He's running onto the football is Tolra. Tolra can't control it, but he keeps on keeping on. And he's pulled off the ball and rewarded for his efforts with a free kick. So good play by the North Melbourne youngster, 16 years of age. And has the free kick 35 metres from goal.
Yes, the player playing the ball was rewarded there. A couple of North Melbourne indiscriminate tackles again. Tolra shooting from about 40 metres out, 45 at the most. Oh, shocking kick from Tolra off the side of the boot and out of bounds on the full. Free kick to be taken in the back line by Doyle. It was a magnificent torpedo kick.
He let himself down, that young boy then, Bernie.
Yes, he did the hard work. Yeah, he did all the hard work to get the free kick. He put his body in very well. And now the kick out will be taken by Michael Doyle. Some of those torpedoes he's kicked this afternoon have been magnificent.
Well, this time he goes with a drop punt. It goes past the 50-metre line. And a good mark taken for Essendon by Meadew, who's done fairly well for his side. And a drop punt high up towards half forward. Good punch on there by Reynolds. Now it goes to the back, being held when he didn't have the football. Looks like McGrath to take the free kick. And he's allowed to play on, which is a little strange. Two bounces, left foot kick is good. Up towards the wing, good punch away for Essendon by Garthwaite. Cracker gathers, somehow gets clear. Hand pass out the back comes to Watson. Watson puts North Melbourne into attack, up towards half forward. Here's a chance for Carey, composed. Shoots for goal with a long one. Just offline, through for another behind to North Melbourne. So the tall players for North Melbourne have been just too good for Essendon. And they look like going on to a very, very comfortable victory. 14-14 plays 4-3. Kick in done by Gadsden.
close to the line. Tolra taken over there by Boyden. So we'll have another boundary throw in. It's at half forward for North Melbourne. And with just 20 minutes left in the match, North Melbourne will win the under 19 premiership for the third time in the last 6 years. They've been in this grand final. This is their sixth consecutive appearance. They've won two and look certain to win a third. Boundary throw in. No one can do much with the football. Garthwaite there for Essendon. And maybe the frustration showing by Essendon players as they've struggled pretty hard, but they've been completely outclassed. Rozelle there for North Melbourne. Kick out towards the centre line area. Angus bursts his way through, kicks the ball up towards full forward. At the back, a chance for another goal for Hay, and he puts it through.
Malcolm, just a shy, innocent, harmless guy who's also a genius.
What's he doing out there?
With electronics.
How do you get the money?
And the day he meets Frank and Judith, his life changes.
What, rob banks?
Malcolm puts his genius to work on the fake job of the century.
Cops wouldn't know where to start looking. He never left his bedroom.
Malcolm. The multi-award-winning Aussie movie, showing for the very first time on television, Sunday at 8:30, here on 7.
Well, the lead for North Melbourne now blown out to 77 points, and got their hands on the flag now.
Tap out there by Ryan for Essendon. Finishes in the arms of O'Donnell. Kick by Tyrrell. Chance for Rocky. Good play by the Essendon Rover. Up towards half forward. Lupton is dumped. Play there by Scholl. The umpire has picked a free kick out of it. Looks as though it might go back to Lupton. Didn't quite pick that one up, Bernie.
Well, I think he paid it for holding the man, but I thought that was an excellent tackle applied there by Paul McCormick.
Lupton's short pass is effective, and the mark's been taken by O'Brien. So O'Brien, you would think, would be within goal scoring distance?
I would say so. He'd be kicking O'Brien from about 40 metres out. On only a very slight angle. Here's a shot for goal from O'Brien. Made the distance no worries. The accuracy right through the middle. Another goal to Essendon. So that's Essendon's fifth goal. They've struggled to get the goals on the board this afternoon. Essendon 5-3. Trailing North Melbourne 15-14. So a big lead to North Melbourne at the 9.5-minute mark of this final quarter.
Well, to give them some praise, at least they've made the grand final when they won the last match of the season to get into the five,
yeah,
then won the three finals to get here.
It has been a great performance, and I think it does take its toll when a side comes from the elimination.
So the bounce back in the centre, 67 points is the, 71 points actually is the advantage to North Melbourne. A free kick now has been picked out of it, and it'll go to Essendon to be taken by O'Brien, and it looks like a 50 metre penalty should bring him up to a game within goal scoring distance. He kicked the last goal from very near an identical position.
Yeah, I think he'd be about 5 metres extra on this kick. Probably kicked this one from about 45, so this may test him a little bit. Yeah, he kicked that one from about 45 metres, made the distance okay, but the accuracy wasn't there, so it's another behind to Essendon.
So exactly 70 points now the lead for North Melbourne. And I'd say that they could prepare themselves for a lap of honour. Kick in by McCormack. Past the 50 metre line. Thump away out wide. Chance for Rocky. He's well tackled, but he gets the hand pass away. Reynolds. Oh, he puts his teammate under pressure. Angus pushed to the ground. And a free kick has been awarded to that player in the back pocket for North Melbourne.
Been some heavy tackling this afternoon, or this morning, from Essendon. On a couple of occasions, they've given away unnecessary free kicks when a ball was trickling over the boundary line.
Angus has kicked towards the wing. Nearly a mark, yes, it's been paid. And it'll go to Tranter for Essendon. Tony Tranter, big ruckman, recruited from Hastings, only 17 years of age. Kicks it up towards the full forward area. Struggle for possession. McCormack is pulled off the ball by Lupton. Good play by the latter on the 50-metre line. chance for Tolra, and he gets the hand pass away right up against the boundary line. He goes after it again, but he can't control it, and will have a boundary throw in as Lupson. He's in the middle of these dust-ups. He's a rugged customer, is Dean Lupson from Sunbury, 18 years of age, and has played a few reserves games for Essendon during this season. Boundary throw in. No one can do much with it, so the field umpire will come in and bounce. Some tired boys there, and more particularly the Essendon players who have chased North Melbourne all day, and at the moment trail by 70 points. The Essendon player Ryan Barrow, kicked by Doyle. Oh, nearly a great mark by Cracker. Play on, says the umpire. Chance now for Essendon through Tonks. Gets the ball away to Kenaway. Kenaway has tackled well. Kicked off the ground by Pennell, but it has already gone over the line, so we'll have another boundary throw-in. Well within scoring distance now for Essendon. It's about 35 metres out from their goal, with just 14 and a half minutes left in the match. Big punch away by Angus. And it goes over for another boundary throw-in, just in front of Scholl. Perhaps a little further away, yes, about 45 metres around from the Essendon goal. So what can they do with it? Reynolds over the top. Pennell, left foot kicker smothered. North Melbourne really striving to restrain the Essendon attempts at goal, and we'll have another ball up. Some unproductive play there.
Yeah, very crowded forward line. Makes it very difficult to get the ball clear and have a shot at goal. North Melbourne bottling up the game.
About 20 players around this ruck contest. It's thumped away by McGrath. Good effort there by Watson for North Melbourne. Chance now for Barrow. He's well tackled. Watson's in there again. He's going to get a possession. Hand pass over the top. Comes to Manara. Manara's kick up towards centre wing. No one can do much with him. Chance for Gadsden. Out wide now. North Melbourne come forward. It's up towards half forward. Nearly a mark. It's been paid. A good effort there for Essendon by Doyle. And at half back, he'll put Essendon into attack. He transfers play across the centre. The mark's been taken by O'Brien, the Chris Mayne wearing lookalike. And he kicks the ball up towards half forward. Essendon, it's really been a struggle for them. The possession now by Tyrrell. Hand pass over the top. Cracker's made good position on the wing. He's got 15 metres spare. Short pass up towards half forward. Watson there. He's bumped off the football. Cracker takes possession again. Short kick in towards the forward pocket area. No mark taken. Carey, his kick has been smothered there by Ryan, and we'll have another boundary throw. So 45 metres out from the North Melbourne goal, we've got a boundary throw in. Essendon player Ryan, Rosell, Palmer. Now for Davies, hard up against the boundary line. No one can really do much with it, so we'll have another boundary throw in.
Palmer's been a very effective player, also for North Melbourne. Playing across that half-back line. Maybe having a run on the ball this quarter, but he's driven North Melbourne into attack on plenty of occasions. Here it is, very congested play again on the North Melbourne forward line. Hurried kick into that forward pocket by Tolra, and it is out of bounds. Another boundary throw in, just next to the left point post.
So Shane Ryan there for North Melbourne, number 23 for the North Melbourne side is Christie. That was the Essendon player as Ryan. Kick out of the ruck contest, out wide. Tranter can't control it. Closely contested there by Carey, and we'll have another boundary throw in. So really only a formality now, the last 10 or 12 minutes of the match. North Melbourne will win the under-19 premiership quite comfortably. Rosell there in the ruck for North Melbourne. Ryan there for Essendon. Neither can get it. Rocky over the top. Now there's a tap on. There's a chance here for O'Donnell for North Melbourne. Steady. Kicks it into the forward pocket. And a great mark taken for Essendon by Burke. 18 years of age. 189 centimetres. Kick out wide. Carey can't mark. It comes to the back. North Melbourne go back into attack. The mark attempted, marked by Manara. Chance now for Boyden. Hand pass over the top, out wide. Chance there for Garthwaite. Kick up towards full forward, and the mark has been taken by Gadsden. Gadsden's kick. Oh, it's a little too far for his teammate. Over the top, and a good easy mark taken there by Davis for North Melbourne. So North Melbourne can do no wrong. Class is really telling, and I wonder whether this is an indication of what might happen in the main game. Melbourne struggling from the elimination final. Hawthorn, of course, have done it pretty well to get into the grand final. And Davis shoots for goal. Good long kick. Nearly a mark. Not controlled, says the umpire, and it goes through for a behind to North Melbourne. Good kick by Davis. Got lots of yardage on that kick. Meterage, should I say. And another behind to the North Melbourne side. So the kick in again by Doyle. Torpedo punt kick out wide. North Melbourne's another chance here. The punch has gone into their forward area. Kick by Pennell out wide. The bounce favours the Essendon player in Meadew. And he's got a little bit of time to steady and kick the Bombers into attack. Up towards Ryan. The bounce favours him. And Ryan inside 50 metres. Kicks to the front of the square. But a good mark has been taken for North Melbourne by Angus. He hand passes it off to his teammate. And a kick out wide. The bounce really favours Rocky. Rocky goes now up towards the 50-metre line. Punch towards goal. A high ball, but a good mark has been taken for North Melbourne by Scholl. They've got players everywhere, North Melbourne. The high ball out towards McGrath. He lets it go for Rozelle. Rozelle looking to hand pass, and he goes back to McGrath. They've got options everywhere, North Melbourne. At half-back, McGrath's kick long towards half-forward. Marking contest. Cracker gathers. Hand pass wide. Chance for Carey. Carey's left-foot kick is smothered. And it goes over the line for another boundary throw-in.
Almost come to a stop there, Essendon.
Yes, they really haven't got much incentive, have they, Bernie, now?
They're looking a little bit tired and a little bit dejected. A big margin now, 15-15 to 5-4, coming up to the 19-minute mark of this last quarter.
They lead by 71 points, North Melbourne. The hand pass comes back towards Essendon out wide. The kick has been marked by Rozelle for North Melbourne. And he plays on. He's got a player loose in Angus in the centre. He gets past. Look at the strength. Big tall fellow. He stumps the drop punt towards the forward pocket area. A marking contest, and it's been paid to Essendon, which is fair enough. He was the man in front. Probably didn't control it all that well, but it's been paid to Darren Burke in the back pocket for Essendon. So yes. Time ticking away. There's the marking contest again.
Yes, may have been a little bit lucky. The North Melbourne player's got his hands on it on that second occasion.
The ball comes out from Ryan. Chance again for Angus. Hand pass over the top. Good strong play by Tolra. Tidied up by Rocky. Now the hand pass comes to O'Brien in the centre. And O'Brien thumps the Bombers into attack. Up towards full forward. Punch away. Here's a goal coming up. No, he gets the hand pass away. A kick off the ground by Ryan. Oh, messed it up completely, the Bombers. And it's rushed through for a behind.
Well, that was good desperation from the North Melbourne defenders.
McGrath, a short kick. Kicks it to himself. Maybe the goal umpire hadn't completed proceedings, so it'll have to go back to the fullback to kick it in.
He was making sure he got the 2 metres there, Robbo. He went about 10 metres.
So the kicking in now is done by North Melbourne with 7 minutes left. Rozelle can't mark. A good punch away by Daffy. Daffy's there again. So is Philandia. Now there's a chance for O'Brien. O'Brien's kick into the pocket, and the mark has been taken by Tonks. So Tonks right on the 50-metre line to kick the Bombers into within goal-scoring distance, and he really did look as though he picked that North Melbourne player out, McCormack, and he took a good strong mark in the back pocket. He's a likely type too, only 182 centimetres from Scoresby, but a good solid player in the last line of defence. The kick out wide, and a free kick has been paid to O'Donnell. Or that Essendon player not too happy. An undisciplined play will result in a 50-metre penalty being given against the Essendon side. So it'll go up towards the centre wing.
Been a little bit sloppy, the Essendon tackling, all morning, really. On a lot of occasions, the North Melbourne player has been in the best position, and the Essendon player has just come in very late and given the free kick away.
Well, that was very undisciplined play. O'Donnell looking to give the hand pass over the top. A free kick, it was a free kick, and you can't hand pass from a free kick. So it'll go back to the centre wing, where the umpire will bounce.
A ridiculous rule anyway. It adds nothing to the game.
So the bounce on centre wing, Rosedale. Good punch away there by the Essendon player, Daffy. It's up towards half forward. Good interception there by Garthwaite. Over the top, the hand pass was from Kennaway. Ball crashed to the ground with O'Brien, and he's going to take the free kick. Yes, you've got the free kick. Go on with it, because it was good, brave play. And he'll kick Essendon into attack. Up towards half forward. No mark. Comes to the ground. Rocky, good gather. Hand pass hits Lupson in the face. Now North Melbourne will go into attack through Angus. Up towards half forward. It's punched away from Reynolds. Now chance for Philandia. Reynolds is in there again. He gathers the football and gets it out the back. Out wide. Chance for O'Donnell. Players nearly slowed up to a standstill. O'Donnell's kick up towards the wing. No mark taken. Big bump by Carey. Puts the Essendon player down. It may have been number 15, Garthwaite. And he wasn't too happy with that. 5 minutes left in the match. So Rosedale and Daffy. Daffy gets the tap out the back. Now there's a chance here for Essendon through Kennaway. He gets it onto his teammate. That Essendon player kicks it up towards full forward. It clean bowls McGrath. Here's a chance for Essendon. Going for goal is O'Brien. Shot is good. And another goal to Essendon.
When you're ready to get serious about sport, get into Meyer Sports. For clothing like the exclusive Reebok Gold Medal range. In top quality fabrics for top sportsmen and sportswomen from $29.99. Fantastic footwear too, from just $89.99. Meyer Sports, for the brands, the range, and the quality you need to succeed. So get into Meyer Sports, the biggest name in sports of all sorts.
The match, they'll feel a bit better about themselves.
Yes, 64 points now, as Pennell tries to get the ball clear. North Melbourne do successfully, up towards half forward. Chance now for, there's a player, Doyle, grabbed around the neck. Cracker gets the ball out wide. Opportunity for Watson. Watson goes for goal and has put it through. Another goal to North Melbourne. So whatever Essendon do, it's answered quickly by North Melbourne.
Yeah, that's a quick reply by North Melbourne. Good play by Cracker. Got the hand pass out to Watson.
He's just as elusive as his brother, isn't he?
Oh, he looks like a very good prospect, Cracker. Only a small player, 165 centimetres, so that may go against him a little bit. But he's certainly got the skills of his brothers.
Gee, we've nominated quite a few outstanding prospects in the North Melbourne lineup. Can you see anyone maybe in the Essendon lineup that could go on to perhaps play senior football?
Well, it hasn't been the best day to see them, I don't think, because they've been outclassed by North Melbourne. And a couple of players, I think that Doyle, who's an excellent kick from the back line, Lupson has had a good go at it. I think O'Brien, he's shown as though he could be a good prospect.
How about Reynolds, a taller player, 189 centimetres from Wynyard in Tasmania?
Yeah, Reynolds has done a bit. There's a few players there that I think Rocky's tried very hard.
Cracker now trying to burst his way through. North Melbourne up on their half forward line. Carey, he thrashes the ball out wide, and a free kick has been given to Lupson. He plays on quickly, gets past Cracker. Short pass out wide. That was an easy mark dropped by Barrow, but he's up to gathering the football again, and he kicks the Bombers back into attack up towards half forward. There's the Essendon player, Ryan, struggling hard. A kick off the ground. North Melbourne strong in defence. His player is Layden. Now Essendon into attack through Davies. He'll have a shot for goal from outside 50 metres up towards the front of the square, and a great mark has been taken for North Melbourne by McCormack. He's done a good job in the last line of defence. He gets the ball wide. North Melbourne now out of defence. Out wide. The high leak by Davis. Now Essendon a chance through Lupson. Lupson comes forward into towards the centre. Up towards centre half forward. Lupson's left foot kick is poor. And he seems to pick that North Melbourne player out in Hay. And he takes a safe chest mark between fullback and centre half back. Very stylish left footer is Mark Hay from South Melbourne. Kick goes over the top of all players, comes to the back to Tudor. Tudor's left foot kick gives Cracker the opportunity to run onto it. He's tackled, hand passes wide, Christie falls over. Good play there by Garthwaite, and striving hard, the Essendon defence have done a reasonable job. Christie there, keeps the ball in, and coming clear for Essendon is Burke. But his kick lands in the arms of O'Donnell. O'Donnell's kick up towards full forward, it goes to the back, running onto it, and he kicks it. It's a goal
to North Melbourne, kicked by Bale.
Meet the Rigadoons, a gang of funny little characters that'll do anything for a cuddle.
I'll do your homework.
I'll clean up your bedroom.
I'll lick the dog for a cuddle.
I'll let you stay up late for a cuddle.
I'll eat your Brussels sprouts.
And I'll love you forever and ever.
The Rigadoon Gang, now available for cuddle. From KidsBiz.
Couple of minutes to go, and North Melbourne 117-41, and the champagne's really tasting good, I think.
Now there's that player who just kicked the last goal, Barwick. He gets it clear now to Davis. Davis's hand pass out wide. Here's another goal coming up. Hay punts for goal and puts it through again.
And it's a great goal to Hay. It looks like he's having a run on the ball now. He's kicked six goals. And a great afternoon's work on the forward line. There's Big Ben and back onto the ground. He led the way for North Melbourne in that first half. Had a bit of a spell on the interchange when he hurt his leg. But here's Hay running in to kick his sixth. A very stylish left footer.
Moves like John Holt.
Yeah, he does. He kicks very much like John Holt. And so that's six goals to Hay. As I said, a great match for him. Been on top of the forward line now, having a spell on the ball.
23-41. You just have to wonder whether the sheer effort of getting to the grand final for fifth leaves the team flat.
Well, I think they're outclassed, Steve, to be quite honest with you. Bernie's mentioned a couple of times during the call that they've just got so many good players. Tall players, composed players, use the football well. Here's another one of them, McGrath, of course, who won the Morris Medal, the best and fairest in the under-19s this season. And they've just had too many good players all over the ground. McCormick on the full-back line, Angus across half-back with McGrath. On the ball, players like Cracker. The big fellow Venner, there he is again. A punch on now by Christie. And here's another goal coming up. Tudor running in. Oh, he hooks it at the last minute. And it goes through for another behind. So the scoreboard really is a true indication. North Melbourne have just been too good. 18, 16, 124. Essendon 6, 5, 41. Tried hard the Bombers. They've just been outclassed. The kick in has been done by Doyle. And even there gives you an idea of just the difference between the two teams. Tudor's short kick has been marked by Watson. And only seconds remaining in the under-19s grand final. This nearly could be the last kick of the match. It's in the hands of Clinton Watson, 16 years of age from the Basin. And a good mixture, the North Melbourne under-19s, the talls and the smalls. Watson's kick across the face. No mark taken. Chance there for Doyle. He kicks it out wide to the members half-back flank area. And soon the ball safely over with Brett Scholl, another 16-year-old. And there's the siren. It's all over for the Bombers. North Melbourne are premiers in the under-19s. And they are elated.
Well, six successive grand final appearances for the North Melbourne under-19 side, and no wonder there's a happy feeling about the club now. Those boys are all set for a celebration. Trouble is, you've got to start too early in the day, haven't you?
I don't know whether we've given the final score yet, Steve.
It's 18-16, 124. 6-5-41, really just a comprehensive win for North Melbourne. So they've not just been good through the season, they've been able to produce just a fantastic performance in the grand final. So it says a lot about the maturity of the players.
Yes, I think just their size and their sheer ability, their natural ability, and perhaps their confidence. They really did tackle it in a fairly confident frame of mind, didn't they, Bernie? I mean, after winning, 20 matches and only losing two in the home and away, they really were of the better side.
Oh, yes, there's no doubt about that. Being the North Melbourne boys, they are a very happy bunch. They have some very class players there and some good prospects to go a lot further than playing in the under-19s. Venner in the ruck was great. And there's the Victoria's coach, Dennis Pagan, who's done a great job with this young North Melbourne side.
Yes, he'll be very proud of his boys, having
just given Essendon a real grand final lesson here this morning. Well, the presentation's not far away. We'll be back with that at the MCG in just a moment.
When the Fabulous Four began to sing, yeah, 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 it was round the time he was king. The mamas and the papas, Keith and Billy Joel, the Stones and the Animals, the good old rock and roll. Deep as our feet, the money for sure.
Thursday on Rafferty's Rules.
There are three contenders and you're one of them.
Rafferty's up for the big promotion. Chief Magistrate.
I've always had the utmost faith in you, Michael.
But a scandal could wreck his chances.
They are now having an affair, and if that gets out, he's done for.
Who's the mystery lady? It couldn't be...
Yeah, I always thought you and Miss Gray would get together.
Are they just fooling everyone?
People just don't want to believe us.
How can you so certain they're having an affair?
Or is this the real thing?
I will stay the night.
Promotion or romance for Rafferty Thursday.
Monday night on 7, a message from a world above.
They have to return.
The search for a lost love.
I know he's alive.
Father is accused of murder.
I should never have let him go alone.
Vincent is left powerless to assist.
I need your help, Catherine.
And he discovers his father's painful past.
He was blacklisted.
Beauty and the Beast, Monday, 8:30 on 7.
VFL Premiership Football, proudly brought to you by Nissan Australia, Carlton and United Breweries, your state insurance office and State Bank Victoria.
It's the curtain raiser to the big one, the grand final in the reserve grade competition between North Melbourne and Footscray. The Bulldogs won their way through after finishing on top of the ladder, while for the Roos, the passage was a little harder coming up through the preliminary final. Both teams have more than a sprinkling of senior talent, as we continue with our coverage of that one day in September. And a very good morning, everyone, for our continuing coverage of Grand Final Day 1988, and what a magnificent day it is in Melbourne so far. I believe earlier in the day it was raining rather heavily down at Portland, but let's hope those showers indeed stay away until after 6 o'clock tonight and the crowd has gone home. We're here for the reserves grand final between Footscray and North Melbourne. Footscray, the red hot favourites, they finished on top of the ladder, two games clear of North Melbourne, and they go into the grand final this morning after the week's rest. Of course, they defeated North Melbourne in the second semi-final, so indeed they should be the fresher of the two sides. Crowd building up all the time, especially in the members, it's rather crowded. But let's check the season's meeting of these sides, Footscray and North Melbourne. In round four, they clashed at VFL Park. Footscray on that occasion was victorious, 19-18 to 10-12. And they met in round six at Arden Street. Interestingly, only a couple of rounds later, Footscray again defeated North Melbourne, a rather low-scoring affair insofar as the Kangaroos were concerned. 3-10, they lost that game to Footscray, 10-9. And of course, in the second semi-final, as I mentioned, North Melbourne getting a little bit closer, 11-14-80 to North Melbourne, 7-11-53. That was at the MCG only a couple of weeks back. As I said, the crowd building up, especially in the members. If you are a Melbourne Cricket Club member, I would suggest if you haven't started making your way to the ground, you might find seating a little bit hard to come by. In the outer, well, it's rather sparse at the moment, but I do believe outside scalpers are doing a roaring trade. Standing room tickets are being sold at the moment for $40, and scalpers are demanding and getting up to $150 per seat, so they're the ones that are happy at the moment. The car park, as you can see from our aerial of the ground, filling up rather rapidly, and when I came past for the North Melbourne breakfast this morning, the cars were coming into the car park again at a rapid rate, and that was about 7:15. So Grand Final Day 1988 is ideal at the moment weather-wise, and we're going to see a top game in the reserves. Peter McKenna and Don Scott are with us in the commentary box, and right now let's go to those two gentlemen to check the lineups of today's two grand final teams in the reserve.
perfect day here it is at the MCG. Magnificent conditions for these players playing in the reserve grade grand final, and well, two very, very experienced sides. And the Footscray side, they've got many, many names that have played senior football. When you go through it, look at that. Young Wigney at fullback. He played in the seniors on Roger Merritt a few weeks back. Fitzpatrick, Linton Fitzpatrick, played a number of games in the seniors. Nicol, Ronnie James there in the forward pocket. David Alday, a former Melbourne player himself. And there's little Tony Liberatore. And in fact, Mark Athorn on interchange was best on the ground earlier in the year against Collingwood. So that's a very, very good Footscray side.
It's almost a senior lineup, the Footscray side. North Melbourne, on the other hand, they've got a lot of experience as well. Both sides, for example, Footscray, average of 31 senior games. North Melbourne, average 39 to 40 games of senior football. But when you take out McCann and also Ackley in the back pocket, McCann at full forward, there's 400 games between two players. So this side, not as...
Ronnie James there in the forward pocket. David Alday, a former Melbourne player himself. And there's little Tony Liberatore. And in fact, Mark Athorn on interchange was best on the ground earlier in the year against Collingwood. So that's a very, very good Footscray side.
It's almost a senior lineup, the Footscray side. North Melbourne, on the other hand, they've got a lot of experience as well. Both sides, for example, Footscray, average of 31 senior games. North Melbourne, average 39 to 40 games of senior football. But when you take out McCann and also Ackley in the back pocket, McCann at full forward, there's 400 games between two players. So this side, not as experienced as what the Footscray side, but nonetheless, they've got some very, very good players. John Longmire from the Corowa Rutherglen, who started and came down as a boom recruit, started as a full forward and kicked goals. Lyle, experienced player in the ruck. David O'Dwyer on the wing, another experienced player, as is Steele. So this promises to be a very, very good game of football.
And the ground looking in really magnificent condition. Those patches you can see have been artificially coloured. It is new turf that has been sown. It's quite sound, and it was decided to colour them rather than just leave it a little bit brown. But it is new turf, new grass, and the way the guys handled it in the under-19s suggests they're not going to have any trouble with their putting out there. Well, I guess we'd have to go for Footscray, wouldn't we, judging by your comments, Don? They've had a very, very good season. I suppose you could say they deserve the premiership, but of course the finals are a different ball game.
Yes, but experience means a lot, and just the same as in the senior side, Hawthorn fellows have averaged over 100 games of senior football. Now this side here, the Footscray side, has averaged only the 31 games, as I said, to 40, but they are very experienced. They've got some very good players, players that have been around for quite a while. But I wonder, Peter, whether some of those players would go on and play league football.
Well, that's funny, you just took the words out of my mouth. I think a lot of these Footscray players will. When you look at Adrian Campbell, very, very good player. Some of the youngsters, Mark Cullen's still a youngster, so is Craig Somerville.
Wigney is a very, very
Wigney,
good player.
Troy Maloney's still a youngster. Now, Linton Fitzpatrick, number 42. Now, Fitzpatrick played some very, very good games at centre-half back earlier in the year. A very defensive player. Of course, Brian Cordy's towards the end of his career. Tatsaris really hasn't come up. David Alday either.
The other player that impressed, we saw him in one game out at Footscray against Geelong.
Big
and
Ruckman.
Yes, Stuart Wigney. No, Scott Wine.
Oh, Scott Wine. The big
he only played for about 5-10 minutes in that particular game, but he does possess a big leap. Interestingly enough, he was let go by North Melbourne. He was in the North Melbourne area from Jacana.
Yeah,
that's right. And he's 6'6", 6'7", a big lad who's got a big future. But David Alday, number 14, who had played for Melbourne, tried out at Richmond earlier in the year, will be leading the ruck division for Footscray this year.
Well, I saw him against Collingwood earlier in the year, and he played an outstanding game in the ruck. So a lot of these players have been in the seniors throughout the year. David Alday, full marks to him for going to Footscray and trying to resurrect his football career. He was, well, in and out at Melbourne, and he's been the same, of course, at Footscray.
Umpires this afternoon, not this morning, used to saying this afternoon, it will be this afternoon shortly, Harris and Vernon.
And a very experienced interchange bench for Footscray with Shane Williams and Brenton Bilchin.
Steve Rebilliard will be keeping us up to date on what's happening on the boundary insofar as the interchange is concerned. First quarter of the Reserves Grand Final for 1988 between North Melbourne and Footscray. Ideal conditions for football. Margaret Alday, won by Alday at the centre bounce. Knock on by Baxter. A chance for Footscray to swing into attack. The ball is driven up towards their full forward position. Long kicks there from Cordy. The goal umpire goes across to grab the one flag, so that score came up pretty quickly. Number 28 for North Melbourne Kerr to bring the ball back into play. Three North Melbourne players over there, and the mark taken by Murphy. Murphy at the left half-back flank. Up towards centre wing, knock away by Spivar for Footscray, and the ball traversing the line, it will be thrown in.
Interesting enough, Michael Murphy, who just kicked that ball, was a teammate of Tony Hall, who is going to line up in the grand final. They both played at Glenelg last year.
Knocked down by Alday, so he started well in the ruck. Chance for Footscray now for North Melbourne through the agency of Scholl. Scholl hooks it across the body, knock away by Tatsaris, getting the ball away from his opponent down there, Sean Smith, and it will be thrown in on the practice wicket area, left half forward flank for the Kangaroos. Once again, Lyle and Alday. This time Lyle gets it down, can't find a teammate. Alday was scragged. Could have almost been a free kick. Booted back for North Melbourne by Smith. And off the hands of the pack. Will it be out of bounds in front of Love? Yes, it is. And also in front of Irvine, it'll be a boundary throw-in.
Well, nothing much happening so far. There's Jason Love. He's played a number of outstanding games, particularly up at the Sydney Cricket Ground a couple of times. There's Jose Ramiro dragged to the ground. Could have been a free kick. All players going in particularly hard. There's a loose ball to Steve McPherson. He's lost it. North Melbourne. Well, that was Buckley trying to get it. Now he leaves it to Ramiro. A quick kick was up towards McCann. He couldn't control the ball. It's shuffled out. Here's a quick kick coming back for North, right in front of the Footscray goal, but it's been taken by Tatsaris. He's gone wide. He's found Peter Baxter. Further afield it goes. This is Wigney. Here's Stuart Wigney coming down the ground with a long floating kick towards half forward. The ball mark is dropped. He's Liberatore. He goes to ground. He's lost it. At half back for North Melbourne, trying to crash his way through there was Kerr. McCann's now up on the ball. North Melbourne trying to bring it out of defence as they bring it around, and the mark has been taken there for Footscray by Ron James. James centres it. Good play by James, and he's found his man, and taking the mark at centre half forward for the Bulldogs is Stuart Nicoll. Now, this will certainly be a score, I would think.
Fair way out, Peter.
Well, he'll only have to kick it from about 42, 43 metres. Should make the distance, I think, Pete. And let's see if he's got the accuracy. A left footer, Stuart Nicoll. And slightly off the side of the boot. And through for one behind to Footscray.
Kicked by Nicoll, so two behind to Footscray to open scoring in this reserves grand final. The Bulldogs, fairly warm favourites. They lead by 2 points. Baxter thumps the ball clear. Chance for Big Wine to pick the ball up. A wild hand pass comes out in the direction of Steele. North Melbourne gain position now. Lyle on the end of a hand pass at right centre wing. Wobbles the ball up towards Dwyer at centre field. And that centre field area does look pretty hard too. A chance for Tatsaris. Fumbled at the crucial moment. Two on one in favour of Footscray. The ball comes out in the direction of Wigney. A long hand pass. Irvine the recipient. He's gone for a short pass out in the direction of Baxter, who marks just a little bit short of left centre wing. Peter Baxter, McCann and Lyle. Footscray, they come out with the ball. The numbers are there. Passmore, that was Nicoll. He kicked it behind for Footscray. Now it's Liberatore looking for some tall timber down there in the goal square. A chance for North through the agency of O'Donoghue picking the ball up, and the mark is taken at the 50-metre defence line by Mark Lyle. Lyle wobbles it up towards centre wing. A few nerves out there possibly at the moment. Steve McPherson only had his head taken off. If he did play the advantage, McPherson took it pretty quickly. Oh, great one-hander. I think that's the big fellow Wine, is it?
That was a great mark by the big fellow. He looked a little all at sea earlier in the game. He seemed to be running around the outside of the pack, not really getting into it, but there, using his strength, being held by one hand.
Gee, that was a good mark, wasn't it?
My word, great strength by the big fellow.
So this young lad from Jakarta. He's directly in front. I think we saw him in the game against the West Coast Eagles, Don, didn't we? Spent a lot of the time on the bench there. from 35 metres out, and the kick looks awkward, but the result might be okay. It is, it's a goal.
Nothing. Footscray, as Don said, looking good. There's the ball brought out of defence by Craig Scholl, who has got a lot of ability. The Footscray defence is very, very strong. Beautiful smother that was. Maloney tried to kick it, and it was a terrific smother by Jason Love, the former Port Melbourne star. And as I said earlier, a couple of times he's played some outstanding games on the half-forward line, usually against the Sydney Swans. McPherson taken to ground. There's Buckley. Gets a quick kick straight up in the air. Hepburn's there for North. Good play by Hepburn, but it's grabbed for Footscray by Irvine. A lot of scrambly play going on. This player can really play. That's Scholl. He gets it further afield, and North come into attack. Oh, the big fly was Sean Smith. He really has got a leap. That was Swass. Baxter loses it. Punched away. Further afield. Chance for North Melbourne at half forward. There's a slick hand pass. Comes out to Swass again. Swass to half forward. And the mark has been taken by David Dwyer.
Interesting, David Dwyer's father, Laurie, is the coach of this side.
Twinkle toes, Laurie Dwyer. He was, an Australian ballroom dancing champion and a fantastic footballer. He was on the wing for many years. There's the kick. David Dwyer, it swings back. I don't think it came back far enough, though. No, it didn't, and it's one behind, two north.
I wonder if David likes playing under his father, because he hasn't played a senior game this year, and so his father mustn't have given him much of a rap.
Well,
not the match committee to have the deciding vote, Don, surely?
Well, at least your father would push you up, wouldn't he?
Well, in North Melbourne, they've chopped and changed their side this year, too, as the ball's brought back towards Steve McPherson. It sits for him beautifully. He'll really show out in this standard, I would think. Steve McPherson, as he brings it to half forward, it's fisted away by the North defence. Here's Stuart Nicol again. Now, Campbell. Adrian Campbell, the boy from Traralgon, a quick kick. Oh, it's taken away beautifully by Brendan Harris. He sprints down the centre of the ground. Hand passes across too far. Umpire said he ran too far, so the ball will be replayed back. Free kick to Footscray.
I think Harris was too happy about that. Probably a good thing we can't lip read. He's a good kick, this fellow, Campbell. That one's certainly no exception. He's looking for big wind down there, or wind. Kerr goes with the educated kick to the boundary line, and it will just get there.
Footscray set up on the forward line with Wind at full forward. The little fellows have really got to get around his feet, because they'll attempt to, the North backman will attempt to punch the ball away. It will come to ground.
McCann got the front position down to Ramiro, whose ancestry, I believe, goes to Chilean parts in South America. Now Buckley. Up towards centre field. Mark claimed by Tatau as he didn't pay it. This is Maloney, one of only a couple of players with long sleeve jerseys. Irvine. The other one was Atkins. Might have been out there with a long sleeve jersey. Out of bounds, 50 metre line. And another boundary throw in.
Well, I think Footscray, Don, looked very strong in defence.
They're not really capitalising on the scoreboard, are they, Peter? It's a pretty lacklustre game. We've played 8 minutes into this, the first quarter, and no side has really got away, although Footscray look as if they could control the game.
Ramiro and Cullen do battle, as once again the ball goes over the boundary line, a little bit closer this time. Probably about 35 metres around from the scoring area. All thumped down by Passmore. And picked up for North Melbourne by Pickering. That's out of bounds again, so the game hasn't really reached any great height so far. Wayne Schimmelbusch, has he retired or hasn't he? $64,000 question this year. Maybe we'll still see Schimmer back in senior ranks in 89. Picked up for North Melbourne by Jason Love. This kick is a very high one. Dwyer trips over or slips over. His father never would have done that, surely. Maloney. And that's another high kick. Could and will be out of bounds on the full. And it will be a free kick to be taken out there on left centre wing for North Melbourne by Harris, number 38. And Brendan Harris with the free kick. Hugs the boundary line with it.
Oh,
strong back for North Melbourne has been brought in by Smith. And he gets up limping, unfortunately. Let's hope he's okay. I think he landed on his left thigh.
He's got an amazing leap, this player, hasn't
unbelievable
he?
Unbelievable leap. Unbelievable. And great courage. He'll throw himself in at awkward angles.
So Smith, a great aerialist. We had a few of those in early Australian history, didn't we? Strong mark taken by David Alday on the last line of defence.
Alday, not known for his kicking ability, but that's not a bad kick coming around the member side. Oh, great strength there by McPherson. He gets it away to Atkins towards half forward. Over the back of the pack. Now, that could have been interference to North Melbourne. It is. And taking the kick will be Robert Kerr at centre-half back. Now, Kerr, again around the member side Alday. Could have been interference then, and the umpire picked it up. Good umpiring against Alday on Mark Lyle. Former basketballer Lyle, a wobbly-looking kick to half-forward. Ramiro couldn't take the mark, and the Bulldogs are able to bring it out of defence again. A nice pass comes across to Alday. Ron James on the left foot towards half-forward. Good, strong play by North Melbourne. There's Wigney. An outstanding game against Roger Merritt early in the year. Darren Steele takes it from him, brings it to half-forward. Awesome, strong work there in the pack. At half-forward, David Dewey is thumped to the ground, but cop one too high, and he'll take the free kick on centre wing. Phil Cronin didn't agree with it.
I don't think there's much doubt about it.
Well, the umpire could have paid the advantage in that case.
Yes, they had a man free in Schwass, but here's Dewey sensibly kicking it towards half-forward. Over the back of the pack. Here's a chance for Harris. Into an open goal, he kicks, and I think he's put it through. Yes.
Nissan Nomad outdrives the competition with breakaway 2.4-litre performance, power steering, value price, and Nissan's two-year warranty. Nissan know-how, building the right cars for Australia.
You need a cleaning service. Do what I do. Here's the Melbourne Big. It's much faster.
The Melbourne Big, the buying guide Melbourne into turning to.
It's one goal apiece, and the difference is 1 point in favour of Footscray, the hot favourites for the reserves flag. No one making much headway. Libra Torre finally does get his kick in to his credit. The ball thumped to the deck over the head of Campbell, knocked further forward by Buckley for North Melbourne. Wigney gets the hand pass. Atkins, the recipient, out towards right half forward. A chance for Spielar. Some 60 metres out, he's gone for a pass. He looked for the tall fellow. That could roll through. McPherson tried to keep it in play. Obviously, it was touched and one behind. Now another point to Footscray, 1-3 to 1-1. It'd be fair to say the game is opened at a leisurely pace, booting the ball back in as Murphy. Umpire calls play on. And a hand pass for North Melbourne comes out in the direction of O'Donoghue. Out towards Irvine. Can't do much with it. The ball over the boundary line in front of Love. It'll be thrown in centre wing.
Maybe we might be a little bit harsh on players of both sides, because quickly looking around the ground, each player is man. They're playing real man-to-man football, and it's hard to get a break when such is happening.
Wine knocks it down. He's doing well in the ruck so far to Spielar. Kick not a good one, though. Marked down there, that's Murphy, at left half-back flank. And he's got to play in front today. Smith did just that. He's rewarded, and he gets up limping again.
He got up high even for that simple mark.
Smith, two marks, two kicks off the hands of the pack. No, says the umpire, that's not a mark, so the ball is shuffled out towards the boundary line. Irvine picks it up. And they can't really find Tatsaris. It's over the boundary line in front of him. That boundary umpire certainly earning his money so far. And another throw in on centre wing. 12 and a half minutes left in the opening term. A little bit down towards the half-forward line for North Melbourne, actually. Maloney's kick was a short one, smothered by the pack. Tatsaris again. He's scragged. And once again, the boundary umpire will be the centre of attraction. Basking in the almost cricket-like sunshine out there. Not as hot as last year's grand final day, mercifully. The players will be happy about that. Very pleasant at the moment. Lyle taps it down. And North worked the ball forward. Picked up out there for North by Buckley. Kick up towards the half-forward line. Smith this time at the bottom of the pack finds Schwass. He gets tackled pretty quickly. He might get a second chance here. Loses it again. Ramiro grabbed. Did he have it? I didn't think so. And Jose Ramiro will will take the free kick. Very tempted to say Cesar Romero there.
There's like another one out there too, Jeff Chandler. He was a very famous...
I don't think he's out there, actually.
Oh, isn't he? He has been named in the squad.
He was in the squad, but I don't think he is out there, Jeff Chandler.
Well, Romero.
Jose Romero sounds like a Latin lover.
Might be.
Well, he could be, too, from Chile. And not a long kick of a football normally, Jose, but he only has to kick this one about 30 metres. He's directly in front, and he has split the centre.
That was a great goal by the little...
Mike Harlem didn't turn his science project in. He turned it loose.
The danger is that once you unleash the power, you'd lose control of it.
Oh, now we are talking hyperspace!
First energy field will go crazy.
Is this like when you told us we could smoke banana peels?
Chain reaction could start.
Oh, you're pulling my zucchini.
Weather could change.
Weird.
And boom! You're all cosmic dust!
Uh-oh. My science project premieres Wednesday on 7.
2-1 to 1-3 now in the first quarter. 10 3/4 minutes left. A good start by North Melbourne. They get booted into attack again by Steele. But Irvine in the road takes the mark. Tackled by Love. North Covent went for the knock-on. Couldn't really find contact with the ball. Scooped out into the open spaces. Ball was booted up towards left half-forward flank. Is that a mark to Lyle? It was. And so big Mark Lyle has the chance. I don't think would be in line for stall gift honours, Peter, but...
I don't think he'd have any pretensions in that department, but he was a very good basketballer at 194 centimetres.
And a good shape too, isn't he? Big fellow.
He's working a bit on the iron, I think. 35 metres up, slight angle. The kick looks awkward. Well, Lyle's not happy, and another behind. De North maintaining their lead. They lead 2-2 to 1-3.
Well, North really could do with a top-class ruckman. I think John Mossop's getting towards the end of his career. Now, this guy could make a footballer. He's very tough and determined, Linton Fitzpatrick. Beautiful kick right out towards the half-back line. Atkins was the flyer over the top. There's Darren Steele. A quick hand pass to Buckley. Buckley towards half-forward, but it's fisted away by Peter Baxter over the line, right in front of the Melbourne members. Peter, of course, is the brother of Darren.
Is he the brother?
I think he's the brother, isn't he?
I didn't think they were related.
I thought he was the brother. Peter Baxter and Darren Baxter.
No, they're not the related.
Are they?
No.
Oh, I thought they were brothers. Well, there's Steve McPherson at halfback. He's working hard, Steve. Oh, he went over the line, nearly unloaded then by Buckley. And, well, I think they are brothers, actually. We might be able to check on that. It's about 20 metres around from the goals. There's Wind. Getting it down. Jason Love's in there. Big Wind again. I think he headed for the boundary line then. He's got backup support as Footscray again. That was Tatsaras bringing it. Yes, it was Tatsaras bringing it around the boundary line. There's Wayne Swass being spoken to by the runner. And he's a promising young player, Swass. 1-3 plays 2-2. A pretty even contest at the moment. Very evenly matched sides. There's a hand pass from Baxter. Back to Atkins. The centre wing. Ball loose. Caught back towards the half-forward line by O'Donoghue, who's doing quite well, and Wine has taken a nice mark.
There's two good marks he's taken, both similar. Maloney's kick up towards the left centre wing. Oh, Murphy didn't have eyes for the ball. Ball booted up for Footscray by Nickel. Now a chance for O'Donoghue. McKenzie it is, rather. He's fumbled at the crucial moment all day, putting him under a lot of pressure. Kerr comes in for support, but it's going to be a boundary throw-in right on the 50-metre mark on the outer side. Alday and McKenzie. And McKenzie gets the front position, doesn't get an effective tap-out. Ball picked up by Kerr again, doing some good work in defence down there. Now, Footscray had the numbers at the fall of the ball. It's not going to help Steve McPherson. The bounce doesn't go his way. And again, we'll see a boundary throw-in. It's on centre wing. 7.5 minutes left in the term. Been a good one for North Melbourne. Had a lot of the ball on their forward line. Steele. A gutsy mark taken by McPherson. Lays the hand pass off. Now, kick is going North Melbourne's way. It's taken by Dwyer. Irvine got one hand to it. Love. Hugs the boundary line. No pun intended. Now this is Buckley. Well, I don't know what he was trying to do with that kick. Ball still in play now. It's out of bounds. Left half forward flank for the Kangaroos, about 55 metres around from their goal.
Just wondering what coaches of either side could do. I think you've just got to let things settle and hope it comes alive a little bit,
well,
don't you?
There's nothing happening.
Yeah, getting that was Pickering trying to get clear. And finally, the ball was booted up towards the centre wing position again. Off the hands of the pack, it's thumped away by Footscray's Nickel. And we'll again see a boundary throw. And well, that boundary umpire is really earning his money at the moment. He must have thrown it at least a dozen times. Mick Malthouse, interested spectator, senior Footscray coach. Some very good prospects in this side.
I tell you, it was also there, the reserves coach, Rod Austin, who's been mooted as maybe a possible coach for Fitzroy or the Sydney Swans. He's been spoken to, we all know that, as the ball is brought down towards full forward. A chance now for North Melbourne, a race for the ball. Dwyer is there, but also is Cronin, and Phil Cronin is able to tap it through for a behind to North Melbourne. So the Kangaroos move on to 2-3, a good start to them. Footscray 1-3, a goal the difference. Out wide, the Footscray player is Gary Irvine. Towards centre wing, he's gone. Nickel was there. He's grabbed by Buckley, a quick kick. And the mark has been taken by Lyle. Lyle at the 50-metre line.
Proving a headache for Wigney.
Yes, he's giving away a lot of height there, Stuart Wigney. Lyle, a nice-looking drop putt. This is close, but it just drifts back and through for a behind. But North doing most of the attacking. There's Mark Lyle. 2-4 North Melbourne. Footscray on 1-3.
Just over 5 minutes left in the quarter. Irvine goes for the short pass, and that's effective. There's Wigney. And Wigney's kick has almost found his opponent at the moment, Lyle, but the bounce doesn't favour him. And Footscray are able to drive the ball up towards their centre wing position. Bulldogs are plenty there at the moment. Comes out to Campbell. Long boot. And the back of the pack, a good mark taken by McKenzie in front of Allday. Gets the hand pass away to North Melbourne through the agency of O'Donoghue. And a strong grab again taken by Harris. From left half-back flank, Harris decides to go long, tries to centre the ball. Cronin was at the back of the pack. Chance for Footscray again as the ball is booted up by Cullen. And North Melbourne now through Hepburn. The ball down again to their half-forward line. They've done a lot of the attacking North Melbourne so far in the quarter. Here's Fitzpatrick. Irvine comes in for backup support. Now it's Wigney getting some space that he desires at left half-back flank. He's gone for a short pass. He's picked out Atkins. Long hand pass again. Now this is James, formerly from Williamstown. And he's debut at Footscray at a very young age, I think around about 15 or 16. The hand pass was not a particularly good one. McPherson, I think it's McPherson, yes it is, has little or no chance.
Well, that all comes back to the mistake by James. He could have gone onto his left foot, but he decided to keep on bouncing and under pressure gave the handball and was brought undone.
Steele at right half back, boots at the centre wing. Schwoss leading in the race for the ball. Out of bounds, member stand side, adjacent to the interchange area.
Very frustrating if you're a forward and a fellow up the ground is continually bouncing the ball because you don't know when to lead or make position.
North Melbourne leads by 7 points in the opening term of the reserves grand final. Liberatore gets the ball out to Atkins. Up towards the full forward position. Allday got a couple of hands to it, couldn't complete the mark. Steele goes to the boundary to line. McPherson having a slight disagreement with an opponent behind the play.
Be unusual.
How many dust-ups has Steve been in over the years?
None. Never. Never.
Well, it's at half forward. 4 foot's great. Oh, it's taken out again for North Melbourne. Playing well, Mark O'Donoghue in this first quarter. Some good shepherding. Allowed Irvine to knock it away. There's Wayne Schwoss, though. He's got it. Good skills, this player.
Good player.
As Wayne Schwoss brings it to half forward, falling over was the North Melbourne player. Smith Tadzaris has grabbed it. Oh. He didn't have it. He got rid of the ball very quickly and then was held. And the umpire right on the scene. Zeno Tatsaris had a purple patch about a year ago in the senior side, but finding it hard to get back in there. Awesome strong work there by McCann. Ball forced out wide. Darren Steele charges after it, and he's quite happy to see it go over the line. But been a fairly lacklustre first quarter so far. 2-4 playing 1-3 North in front.
And Footscray have made a change. They've got Wind off and brought Shane Williams on, so they're going for a little bit of mobility.
Well, Shane's a very good player. He's been at a few league clubs. There's a quick kick by Baxter towards half forward. The mark has been taken down there by McKenzie, who looks a pretty promising player down there. I think he's at fullback at the moment. He's doing an excellent job. Brings it to centre wing. This is Hepburn. And the ball held up in the breeze, a swirly sort of a breeze. One certainly won't affect the result of it. Again, it holds up in the wind. Buckley is the man trying to take the mark. There's Shane Williams that we spoke about a moment ago. Oh, a free kick.
I think Shane played also in a Richmond Premiership side.
He might have, too, and he played. He certainly had a stint at Geelong.
Yeah, and St Kilda.
At St Kilda, too, was he?
I remember that.
Don't know about that one.
Very quick if it was. Schwoss, that kick was pretty quick. And Footscray's defence standing firm. Mark taken by James, who relays it to Tatsaris. Tatsaris had a few injury problems. I'm not quite sure exactly what it was or what they were, but that would have been one of the reasons why he hasn't been able to cement a regular place in the seniors.
He's a pretty tough customer.
Yeah. So a boundary throw in, close to quarter time. We've got just over a minute to go in the opening term. Hepburn and Alday. Alday with the big leap. Hit Buckley on the back of the neck, actually. Atkins farms out the hand pass. The umpire, in the meantime, has given a free kick. And the recipient will be Atkins at the 50-metre defence line. Gets plenty of distance with that kick, too. McCann in front. Haven't seen much of him so far in the first quarter. Harris's kick is a short one. James in front. Now a chance for Maloney. Not a great hand pass. It'll be picked up for North Melbourne down there. By Pickering. It's out of bounds again. A little bit of cloud building up towards the horizon, so maybe the forecast of showers later in the day could materialise. Tony Liberatore with the free kick at right half back. Waiting at the back is Atkins. A nice fork. Svilar. A little bit slow to get rid of it. Campbell. Svilar again. Into the forward pocket. The mark for Footscray has been taken by Nickel. Nickel decides to get things moving pretty quickly. That was good play to Cullen. He almost played on, didn't he, Peter?
Oh, well, I think the big question was, did he mark it before the siren? I think he did a split second before.
Well, it's not the siren, it's when the umpire declares the
end before. Yes, that's right, and it was a very fine line. And, well, he's right in front, Cullen, and should make no mistake with this one. Mark Cullen puts it through.
So at quarter time, let's check the scoreboard in the reserves grand final. Cullen going right on the bell, 2-3 to 2-4. North Melbourne leads by a point.
What if they work out they're paying the highest taxes in Australia?
Tell them everything's fine.
And the state debt?
Look, the numbers are too big for them to understand.
Yeah, I want to know what our policies are.
Tell them nothing. Just concentrate on me.
But what?
I said, tell them nothing. Listen. Let's just get through this election. We'll deal with it after that.
Why won't Labor debate the issues or talk about their budget? Why do they run away from embarrassing questions? Why an election now? What is Labor hiding from us? Authorised by DeKemp Liberal Party Melbourne.
That's wonderful.
Now from Breville comes Fingertips, an amazing new do-it-yourself massager that combines the benefits of modern physiotherapy and advanced technology with the ancient art of hand massage to relieve tension or ease muscular aches and strains. Breville Fingertips Massager. Just like having a trained masseur in the family. From Breville, the better ideas people.
To make a perfect serve every time, you need great control. Like this new NEC microwave oven. Electronic touch controls allow you to time meals to perfection. 5 memories, including pause, offer you versatility as well as speed. And it has the extra capacity for big serves that leave the competition cold.
Good game.
But this is my favorite serve.
It's another top performer from the NEC range.
Born to fly, born to run away like an eagle.
Like an eagle.
Born to fly, born to get away. Get away. Born to fly, born to get away. I was born to fly.
the only way to stay ahead of the game.
We have the people, the technology. We're ready to respond to a crime being committed in only minutes. Your call. But you must call D24 direct on 11444.
3 minutes VKC. Only full box away VKC.
If you need the police in a hurry, call D24 direct on 11444.
Melbourne leading by 1 point at quarter time. Goal kickers Romero and Harris for the Kangaroos. Wine and Cullen for Footscray. Cullen getting one right on the siren. John Scott, how did you see the first quarter?
Yes, well, as we mentioned through that commentary, the first quarter was a very lackluster affair. And obviously the coaches agreed, especially the Footscray coach. He got wind off. That's Rod Austin on screen there, and brought Williams on to get a little bit of rain. But then again, I looked around, what changes could you make? I don't think you could make any, because each player was being manned up, and it's very hard to get away in that situation when players are manning up.
1 point the difference at quarter time, the main game three quarters away. And one of the players we'll be keeping our eye on there, could be the match winner for Melbourne, Sean White.
Recruited from Ireland in 1995, Sean White has proven, for Melbourne at least, to be the best export from that land since the Leprechaun. Sean learned the basics of the Australian game playing the Gaelic code in his home country, and it didn't take long for him to show Demon fans that he could easily adapt to the more physical aspects of VFL football. White came of age in 1987, his clearing dashes from defence stamping him as one man who was a driving force behind Melbourne's return as a football power.
And players scattering to take up their positions for the start of the second quarter. Footscray trailing by 1 point. Go down to the boundary line, and again, a good morning to Steve Ribbit.
Good morning, Pete. Thanks very much. As Rod Austin was mainly complaining that his players were a little indecisive and not too happy about the way the throw-ins were coming about either. As for Dwyer, Laurie, well, he was feeling his players a little bit overawed by the occasion. Just, come on, fellas, let's forget the nerves. Let's play some football. Both coaches reasonably happy with defence, but wants them to kick some goals.
I think we'll agree with that. Thanks, Steve. Second quarter, 1 point the difference. North Melbourne leading in this Reserves Grand Final for 1988. Steve McPherson trying to barge his way through.
Interesting, that bounce. It is certainly getting up in the air. When the umpire bounces that ball, it is rock solid in that ground, in the centre there. Very hard to judge if you're a ruckman.
I think that bounce about 20 feet, I think. All day with a big leap. Spivar overruns it. Gets a hip and shoulder for his trouble. Now Atkins for Footscray. Centering kick, hooks it across his body. A couple of fumbles down there, and finally booted away by Donoghue. McKenzie was there, the blonde, number 55, and it's out of bounds at the 50-metre line.
I like the way that McKenzie runs at the ball. I reckon he's going to be a player, that kid, number 55.
Played one game against the West Coast Eagles this year, and I thought unlucky to be taken off the ground.
Murphy in front. Liberatore can't get clear. And there's Donoghue for North Melbourne, driving them clear. Up towards the centre wing position, off the hands of the pack, and knock on, live in front of all day. Now this is Schwoss. I think Peter, he won the Morris medal, didn't he, last year?
Right.
Gets the hand pass, effective, to Love. Up towards full forward, almost a juggle. Mark dragged in by Longmire. That's out of bounds on the full.
On play, we haven't seen Longmire. He's playing at centre-half back in the reserves earlier in the season, or later in the season.
Free kick going to Jason Love. They're giving number 40, shouldn't they? Instead of 39, that it could have been 40 Love.
Oh, so early in the morning.
That's a way to remember. Love, right on the boundary line. That's not a bad sort of a kick. Oh, that is good. And a goal.
Magic. An amazing capacity to do that. He does that time and again, Jason Love, Don.
Well, that's what he's in the game for. He doesn't do much else except goals. And he has got to kick goals. If he can get a little bit more consistency into his game, he does flash in and out of play. Originally tied to Essendon. I think he tried to make it out of Essendon and then was snapped up by North Melbourne. But has played a couple of games on the forward line for the seniors this year.
He was an outstanding player at Port Melbourne before he came to the VFL. Real goal sneak. There's all day doing the ruck work. Steve McPherson was there also. It's knocked away straight to McCann. And McPherson in after it again. He's playing well, Steve. And a long driving kick right up towards full forward. But look at that. Good mark. Good judgment, Brett McKenzie. Awkward looking kicking style. He might have to work on that a bit. There's all day over the top. Atkins, a lovely hand pass out wide to Vila. Towards half forward or full forward, in fact. And McKenzie. Again, McKenzie there looking very, very good in defence. Over to O'Donoghue. Now the kick is wide. Shane Williams taps it to the line in front of the members. a little experienced one there, Don.
Well, that's the little ankle tap. It should be reported. Kicking.
The Lou Richards one, I think, that one. Well, McCann doing the ruck work. It was a pretty friendly one, actually. Darren Spiel. McPherson again, looking for his teammate in Williams, but Steve McPherson's working very hard, Don.
He is a very experienced player, Steve. In actual fact, he was best on the ground on this particular game, and on this particular ground against, I forget the team, but he played a sensational game here one day.
Here's Liberatore with a quick kick towards half forward, and again, a scrambly passage of play, and again, it'll be a throw-in.
And this time it's only about 5 to 10 metres from the behind post. Number 30 for Footscray is Vilchins, who I think got a vote or two in the Brownlow in one game, one senior game. Shane Williams putting his body in front. Ball out of bounds, so it's hustled a little bit further around the boundary line. Yes, I think he got a one or two voter in one match. He didn't play that many, so obviously he caught the eye of the umpire. This is Liberatore. Gets the hand pass out. Kick further forward for Footscray by Nicol. That looked as though it was out of bounds. It was, says the umpire.
And the Footscray table were near us at the Brownlow, and they all burst out laughing. I don't know why, Pete. When Brenton Vilson's got a vote.
Well, it was puzzling, wasn't it?
Probably dropped the next week.
Terry Wallace. I don't think he got one vote, did he? McCann to Murphy. And here's one of the favourites.
The umpire's picked out a free kick, and it's against Shane Williams.
Murphy's taking it. Murphy just up from the back pocket.
I thought Murphy tried to run through McPherson.
Murphy's kick to centre wing. Knocked down by Wigney. And picked up for North Melbourne by Harris. Harris's kick is a high one. And bounces about 20 metres in the air after it hits the turf. Well, Atkins got one too high, I would have thought. Cronin drives Footscray forward. Campbell in the road. They obviously think highly of him, giving him that number. Number 3, worn for many years with great distinction by Ted Whitten, of course.
And Alan Stoneham.
And Bernie Quinlan said he's the best player to come out of Traralgon since Bernie Quinlan.
It's after that. Bernie Quinlan, obviously. Yeah. So 1 point. Big pack of players, and just about everyone misjudged it. Baxter drives Footscray forward. Now there he is again, McKenzie, doing some great work in defence.
Yes, yeah, beautiful play, and a long kick too. And Mark at half forward, and the umpire calling the play on, not allowing that mark. Good football. It comes towards half forward. In fact, that excellent piece of play was by Liam Pickering, number 58.
Very Irish name.
Well, it's at the 50-metre line again, not a lot happening. One goal only, the difference. North Melbourne in front, but very scrambly. Here's Simon Atkins, is playing very, very well. Commentator's dream, Atkins, with the long sleeves and the red hair. Shane Williams. Oh, well done by Brenton Harris to sprint away and kick long. Beautiful football. Longmire's up there in front. Over the back is David Dwyer. He tries to hook it back. I think he's put it out. No, it could be a free kick for in the back. He did put it out on the full. Footscray player's not happy about that. It might have been a little bit Tiggy Touchwood. The umpire said he was pushed in the back.
Interesting to reflect on how the ball got down there. A handball too hard by Shane Williams on the ground to Nicol. He should have just patted the ball across.
Well, the umpire was right. David Dwyer taking the free kick, shoots, and goals.
It was just that time of the year. We were a bit stretched financially. We were thinking of getting by on less house insurance cover. I remember turning the corner, coming home from school, and there were fire engines in the street, and smoke, and the kids were very excited. Somebody's house is on fire. It was our house. We were fully covered, thank heavens, And Esso rebuilt the house. And I think of what could have happened to us.
So North Melbourne taking the game right up to Footscray, and they lead by 2 goals at the moment. Early in the second quarter, Atkins went in solidly, so too did Love. Now Buckley, oh, holding the ball, says the umpire. Now the advantage rule played, it's gone to Cronin, the free kick. Cronin, straight down the ground. And McKenzie at the back, has he taken the mark? Didn't get first touch, says the umpire. Chance for Footscray again through the agency of Nickel. Now, is it out of bounds or is it going to be a free kick? It's out of bounds, certainly. Left forward pocket for the Bulldogs. Nickel with McCann. They nullify each other. Down to Liberatore. Nickel again. It's very scrambly. Covered in there. Liberatore gets it out to Atkins. Sort of almost with that red hair and long sleeves. A clone of Brad Hardy, if you'd like. He won a Brownlow in a similar livery, didn't he? Three is Campbell, and here's the chairman of the North Melbourne Football Club, Bob Ansett. And there's another early riser for the North Melbourne breakfast this morning. Nickel tries to soccer it off the ground. That took a play of hand with him. Cullen grab. It's a scramble at the moment. Steele, oh, put it out of bounds on the full. That is certainly not turning on a threepenny bit. Darren Steele not too happy with himself.
North Melbourne made a change, and coming on Anthony Rock, and going off Liam Pickering. Rock going into the forward pocket.
I wonder if he's in a relation to Barney Rock, who plays over in Ireland. Oh, it's a very Irish name. We've got Liam Pickering, we've got Murphy out there.
Yeah, they're brothers, Peter.
That's the Baxter's This is McPherson, right on the boundary line. Going pretty close with that kick. We'll wait on the goal umpire, and only one behind.
He really is a beautiful kick, McPherson. There's a score, 2-5 to 4-4, but that just missed that kick from right on the boundary line.
Very, very close. Footscray need goals, and here's more of an Irish connection. Murphy brings the ball back into play.
Yes, and they had high hopes for Michael Murphy this year, but might take a year or two to settle down to our way of football. Well, there's the quick kick for Footscray, and that is by Nickel. A great looking snap. It's a goal.
That was a magnet.
Points the difference. North in front as Atkins brings it towards full forward. A lovely lead. This time McKenzie's found out because they've moved Campbell to full forward. And this player is a very, very talented player.
It's been a really constructive forward play we've had, isn't it?
Lovely to see, isn't it, when a guy delivers it like that. Well, Campbell, lovely lead, long kick, and he should kick this from... Well, he's gone right back to the 50-metre line, but the man will run up on the mark, and it swings back and through for a goal.
I think Bernie Quinlan's right. He is a class player, this fellow. I think you could teach him a bit about kicking. I know it was a goal, but I shook my head when he put it onto the boot because I thought it was going to go through for a behind.
Well, it did go right to left, didn't it? And we watch here in replay, and there's nothing a fullback can do when there is a pass delivered in such a way. And that actually did swing through the air like a golf shot. Did it ever. And that young Atkins has got terrific natural skills, that Simon Atkins, number 23.
Back into the centre. So Footscray starting to get their act together. We can't say belatedly, still in the second quarter, but the game's sort of hotting up a bit as Shane Williams drives Footscray forward. Up towards Campbell again, came out with a full head of steam. Steele goes for the hand pass. The recipient is Kerr. Liberatore was late on the scene. Chipped into Dwyer, then turn on to Buckley. Buckley from right centre wing, down towards full forward, and a good passage of play sees the mark for North Melbourne taken by Longmire.
Well, he's another class player, and he also comes from the Murray River area. In actual fact, my grandfather played for the club Rutherglen, and they've now combined with Corowa and call themselves Rutherglen Corowa.
Should be in abundance this morning, Don. Down towards the goal. That looks pretty good, and he's put it through.
Presenting Nissan's award-winning four-wheel drive freedom machine, Pathfinder.
It's a beachcomber, a mountain climber, a highway cruiser, bush hiker, night stalker. Come and drive Pathfinder.
Nissan Pathfinder, now with even better performance. Now in two exciting models at your Nissan dealer. Nissan know-how, building the right vehicles for Australia.
And there's the score, and still 5 points the difference. I was just thought he was going, Don was going to tell us what Longmire had for breakfast any moment. The ball's at half four. This is Tadzaris for Footscray, bringing it out on the left foot. Oh, almost a good mark to Kerr, but Cullen charges after it. He's a left footer as he hooks it back. Now, Campbell at the back, McKenzie at the front, and it comes off the hands of both players. Now, both those guys in future years you might see in the seniors regularly, Campbell and... course his opponent McKenzie. McCann, I wonder if this will be his last year at North Melbourne, Don.
Well, he's been very disappointing up to date, hasn't he, Stephen?
Well, there's Kerr trying to bring it away. Cullen hooks it back to the pocket. Murphy is there. He'll probably head for the boundary line. No, he doesn't. He gives a straight to Liberatore, who tries to centre it. The bounce will probably beat Darren Steele. It does, over the line in the forward pocket.
Well, interestingly enough, 10 years ago to this day, Stephen McCann was playing in a senior grand final for North Melbourne.
Well, I think a lot of people forget that he did play a number of outstanding games also for North Melbourne. A lot of people remember his bad ones. As North bring it out of defence, wide, and the mark has been taken by Brenton Bilchins.
Bilchins, number 30. The right centre wing centres the ball. And the mark to Baxter. And the sun's gone behind a cloud. Overcast creeping in now. Let's hope it stays fine for the big one. Peter Baxter from half forward. Over 50. Drop punt will be pretty close. Now, was that touched? What in the goal on par for this? What's a goal?
No, I didn't think it would make the distance then, because he really did get underneath that, Peter Baxter. He got close to the man on the mark, right on the 50-metre line, and I thought, well, he'll struggle to make the distance. The ball went very high. Now, here we go. Watch this. He got very, very close to the man on the mark. The ball holding up there. The congestion of players. Well, and actually, everybody must have missed that. I thought someone at least lay a hand to it.
The North player tried to palm it through, but had he just laid a hand on, it would have been okay. 1 point the difference now in favour of Footscray. They hit the front after that goal to Baxter. Now a high tackle, that was on Wigney. And Wigney should take a free kick at midfield. Comes from, I think it's Leon Gather, isn't it, Don?
What, yes, they operate a farm next door to the Wallaces.
Good dairying country down there. Wigney's kick drops a little bit short. Liberatore gets the hand pass out. And the snapshot at goal for Footscray by Cordy was off target. One of the more experienced players in their lineup, 5-6 to 5-4. Former Victorian Premier, Sir Rupert Hamer.
With his Hawthorn tie on.
Yes, mad Hawk fan for many years. Harris. There's the hand pass out to Steele. North Melbourne go forward again. Ball driven up towards their left half forward flank. That was by O'Donoghue. And ball out of bounds about 65 metres from goal.
He's played well, Mark O'Donoghue, number 49 in defence.
Good tackle by Cullen. Sees the ball spill free and he comes up with it. Well played, son. Ball out towards the centre wing position. Just near the interchange area. And again, we'll see a throw in. 11 and a half minutes left in the second quarter. Game has sort of moved into another gear in this term after a relatively slow start. We saw only four goals kicked in the opening term. Both coaches had plenty to say at quarter time. That could have almost been in the back to Romero. The umpire says play on, trying to do just that as McPherson fires out the long hand pass, taking it to Spiva, who takes it back in turn from Cordy. The knock-on wasn't successful from Nicol. Now it comes to Atkins, back to Spiva. This could be a goal coming up to Footscray. Well shepherded by James. Runs his full distance and has put it through. Good goal.
Dick reckons he's the one. Andrew says not likely, son. Bondy's planning to give him a run. They all want to be Chewy's top gun. Larry Ray.
1000 continues the tradition of Australia's great race. Be at Bathurst October 2nd and find out
who's gonna be
top gun. 42 now to 34. Great goal by Spiva. North Melbourne swing into attack. They need the quick reply if they can. They led at quarter time by a point, but Footscray through Cronin get out of danger.
He's got Mark Cullen on the centre. We get the weight underneath that. Schwass was the big flyer to punch it away. Well, look at the pace of big Mark Lyle there.
Got a picture on the wall that moves well, faster that was, than him.
There's another pacey player in David Alday. Now, North Melbourne bring it out of defence to half foot. All the markers dropped by David DeWire. Should have taken that one. This is Cronin, Phil Cronin, formerly, of course, of St Kilda. Shane Williams does well to break away. Beautiful pass to Baxter. Oh, he might get run down here. Almost, but he gets the kick in. Campbell in front of McKenzie. Good use of the body. Oh, ridden into the ground was McKenzie. This is Liberatore getting it out to Svilar again. Back it comes. He was looking for Liberatore. Let's see if he can get it. Oh, great play, Atkins. Beautifully as he gets it to James. James will straighten up. Hand pass to Cordy. Cordy into an open goal. Great team play.
Well, two good goals gone by Footscray.
Oh, good. They had a lot of options in that attack on goal. And all set up.
Yeah, I must agree with you, Peter, about Atkins. He has got amazing ability, but why hasn't he got a senior game? That is the interesting question. We see there James now across to Cordy. Good play, Footscray.
Has he played any senior games, Don? Simon Atkins?
Quickly look down. No, he has. Well, he's played three, and they were last year. Didn't play anything this year.
Well, I think he'll play a few next year. Looking at his skills today.
Well, he's had 10 kicks.
Well, he's a good player. There he is, on screen with the red hair. 48. Plays a 34. So Footscray just starting to get on top with 9.5 minutes of play left in the second quarter. They really are teaming well. And Liberatore looks as though he's copped one under the eye there.
Should and wipe it all over his face, look a little bit more ferocious.
Well, at that height, you're bound to cop plenty around the head. There's Brendan Harris with a quick kick towards half forward. Sean Smith, the high flyer, gets onto the left foot. He was looking further afield. Now it's a chance for Cronin. Oh, he's lost it. Charging after it for North is Anthony Rock. He's on the boundary line. He hooks it back towards the goal square. Some pushing and shoving. Over the back is Dwyer. Onto the left foot. Oh, smothered beautifully down there. Oh. Ramiro ran into the post, but what a good smother that was by Gary Irvine, number 47.
And there's Cloud looking rather threatening out towards the west now.
Getting very dull.
It is, isn't it? Not the game. That's hotted up. Let's hope it stays fine for the big one. Ground is pretty hard, as we've mentioned. McPherson in front of his opponent, Steele. It's out of bounds, about 55 metres out. Alday with Hepburn. Well, Hepburn had long sleeves on in the first quarter, didn't he?
He did.
Out of bounds again.
Stephen McPherson possesses a lot of strength. The way he ripped the ball out of that pack.
Shane Williams on the screen. One of the veterans on the side. Hepburn again with Alday. That knocked down two Williams. Out to Atkins. Over the head of Baxter. He had plenty of options there. This is Steve McPherson. One of their best players so far. McPherson over the back. There's McKenzie. Backup support from Schwass. That's almost out of bounds. Good tackle, Cullen. So a boundary throw in left forward pocket. For the Bulldogs, 7.5 minutes left in the second quarter.